match that many believe is the real World Cup final, the holders of the crown against the heirs apparent. But for now, all eyes are on Diego Maradona.
Maradona was an absolute genius on the pitch. Capable of creating magic moments, he was feared throughout the football world.
When Maradona went round five people like they don't exist.
It's important that we cut off the supply to him.
We have got to put a 35-yard exclusion zone between us and that goal.
But he was a flawed genius, and perhaps the greatest demonstration of this conflict was the game against England in the 1986 World Cup, where he famously scored Argentina's first with his hand and then went on to score what most people consider to be the greatest goal ever scored in a professional game. Maradona loved his watches. Famously, he always wore two, one on either wrist. One was set to Argentina time and the other set to local. I said to a friend of mine recently that he could have just bought a GMT, to which my mate replied, "Yeah, but Diego was a baller." And there is absolutely no doubt about that. Maradona loved Rolex and Hublot in particular. But even in his relationship with watches, he was never too far away from controversy, often receiving watches from the Camorra, the local Naples mafia, to having two Rolex literally stripped from his wrists by the local police. Today, in the week that the great man died, and in tribute to one of my absolute favourite footballers of all time, we look at Maradona's watches. The Camorra were a mafia-type organisation who were very much involved in Neapolitan life during Maradona's time at Napoli. In fact, there are some alleged rumours that they helped with Maradona's world record transfer fee in 1984, but these rumours were never verified officially. According to the recent documentary by Asif Kapadia, they offered protection to Maradona and a regular supply of cocaine. In return, Maradona was often asked to attend at the opening of new business, sign autographs, and get some photos taken for the papers. In 2006, when Maradona was visiting Naples to play in a charity match, the police literally stripped the two Rolex Daytonas from his wrists. The tax police had a judicial order to seize anything within plain sight in order to pay off some of his 30 million euro in back taxes. At the time, the watches were probably worth around 10,000 euro, but Napoli police reported that Maradona was very polite, very gentle, and very calm throughout the incident. In 2010, Maradona became a brand ambassador for Hublot. This partnership has produced a handful of Maradona themed limited editions. For the 2010 World Cup, produced a monster 44.5mm Maradona Big Bang limited edition black ceramic chronograph with his signature on the dial and his profile engraved onto the case back. This was later followed by a 48mm wide Hublot King Power Diego Maradona limited edition available in matte black ceramic, or the 18 karat gold version, which was most seen on Diego's wrists in later life. In 2016, Maradona even offered a Hublot Big Bang Unicode to Pope Francis, who thought he had enough watches in his collection and opted to auction it off. So Maradona loved his watches, but as with much of his life, even this aspect was less than straightforward. But most importantly, Diego Armando Maradona is in the top echelon of 3 to 4 of the greatest players who have ever graced the game of football and will never be forgotten. He was a true icon, and maybe, just maybe, one of these days, my friends across the pond might get over that hand of God. Good luck, Diego. Maradona, arranca por la derecha el centro del fútbol. Colombia, y es el tercer que toca para Maradona, siempre Maradona. Maradona.